Thank you. would don't want to dampen the spirit of excitement. But if you do ask, it should be respectful in your love to celebrate guests. Remember, each family wishes to put their names, their friends, and now so they want to cross that stage. Please allow us to introduce one of our student partners, Pastor Sharp. Pastor Sharp will bring you greetings on behalf of our students.
Thank you. also honor today the deputy foundation, made up of citizens throughout our community and community leaders. They are representing the Chattanooga area, and they're interested in the success of our students. They work to raise the reputation of our college. They are ambassadors in the organization. The foundation was a Hall of Fame fundraiser, has raised over $300,000 over the past 3 years to provide scholarships for scholarship students. We appreciate the community leaders and their committed community leaders with the members of the CVCC Foundation. Her goal is to work in the field of public relations. Let's congratulate both of these people. in essence, continue to sharpen your skills. Now you have the tools necessary to navigate your future. As Ralph Waldo Emerson said, do not follow where the path may lead. Go instead where there is no path and blaze a trail. Congratulations and best wishes for your continued success. Now, it is my pleasure to introduce our commencement speaker for today. Ms. Susan Wiggins has been with the W.C. Bradley Company since 1980. The Product and Health Company is an international marketer of quality leisure lifestyle products featuring well-known brands such as Charcoal, Tiki, Lamplight, Zepco, Quantum, Fenora, and others. And they are also local real estate development, including, among others, the Eagle and Phoenix Loft, the Condominium, Sonoma Center, the Rapids, and the Brookstone Center. Susan has served as Vice President of Stakeholder Relations since 1992. She became the first woman officer to serve that company in that capacity. Prior to joining W.C. Bradley, Susan held the position of Marketing Officer of Trust Company of Columbus, where she was the first woman hired to be an officer for the bank. Susan is a native of Hatchachevy, Alabama, and has spent significant time in Canada, where she was born. She holds a BA degree in psychology from the University of Alabama and has one son, Frank. Susan has received numerous awards, including the W.C. Bradley Company Spirit Award and the Girl Scout Woman of Achievement Award. She is also the recipient of the Dedicated Service Award from United Way Women Helping Women and CVCC Hall of Fame inductee for distinguished service. In addition, Susan was honored as a recipient of the United Way E. Abbott Turner Volunteer of the Year Award. She has served on numerous civic and professional boards, including past chair of the Better Business Bureau and president of the Columbus Advertising Federation. Currently, she is serving as chair of the Chattahoochee Valley Community College Foundation on the Downtown Phoenix City Redevelopment Authority Board. And she also served as the lay leader and pastor parish relations committee chair for Epworth United Methodist Church in Phoenix City, Alabama. She was also involved in the formation of the East Alabama Riverfront Development Organization. For the past 39 years, Ms. Wiggins has had a unique opportunity to work for three generations of the family founder, W.C. Bradley. The name W.C. Bradley has stood for integrity and stewardship for 134 years. Susan is passionately committed to the concept that, and I quote, "It is up to each of us in the company to keep it so." A frequent speaker of professional groups, Susan's message is always focused on positive empowerment and responsibility that each of us has to change the world for the good. Please join me in welcoming our speaker for today, Ms. Susan Wiggins.
Well, looking at this room with this kind of support behind you, Professor Schroeder has asked me to do this. I'll have to admit, I was honored, and I got a little puffed up. And you know, everybody needs a best friend, because best friends keep free, right? So one of my best friends, and some of the people in the room know this woman, so they'll understand, Helen Johnson, who works at Synovus. So I was telling Helen, and probably bragging a little bit, that I was getting to do this, and she said, seriously, Susan, look, the speaker at a college commencement service is like being the body in an Irish look. They need you there so they can have a party, but they really don't expect you to say a lot. So I will honor that. we were told by the president of the foundation that when CSU asked for that, made that request, they said two things. They said the Coca-Cola Foundation never does endowments, and they never gives that large. So the chairman of the Coke Foundation was surprised when not only did they approve, but unanimously and enthusiastically they approved. That's just the kind of guy the attorney was. He was the same in the grocery store or the border. And he, he believed in serving others. It was that simple, and he believed in loving others. He was once interviewed by Forbes magazine of Brenda Sadovas, which is the best company in America to work for. Mr. Turner was chairman of Sadovas, a private company, the board of Coca-Cola, and many other people. And so this guy said, what is your business strategy for the successful companies you run? And he said, we love each other. And the reporter said, the writer said, no, I mean, your business strategy. And Mr. Turner said, love and we care about each other, And he said, well, I'm really looking for your business model. And Mr. Turner said, look, we care about each other, we're one of those kind of we are. It was interesting when I read the story later, why we did not quote that. But Bill Turner really was one of the greatest leaders that ever was and one of the most successful. So I close with the last words in his book that he wrote, Observing Leadership. Even though I'm in the autumn of my years, I remain focused on the future. And while I have a vision for what I want that to be like, it's more important that members of my family in all its forms, birth, company, church, and community, have their own common vision of what they wish to see happen. It is my hope that my family will build on the foundation that is here and that they will dream great dreams, because no one ever got excited about small dreams. If we continue to dream great dreams, we will continue to accomplish great things. So graduates, looking at you today, I know his wish for the world and the future lies in you.
virtue of the authority vested in me by the governor, the chancellor, and the board of trustees of the Alabama Community College System, and upon the recommendation of the faculty and the dean, I am pleased to confer upon you the appropriate degree and or certificate to which you are entitled, with all rights, privileges, responsibilities, and pertaining thereto. Congratulations.
Graduates receiving credentials in the area of general studies and the Associate of Arts degree or the Associate of Science degree, will you now come forward to receive your diplomas? Aileen Wilkinson. Jones. Brianna Jackson. Sequoia James. Aaron Brown.
Thank you.
Brittany Baker.
Jacob Colquitt.
Sarah Gutierrez. Kinsey Strike. Stacy Quinnell.
Aretha Gray.
Jr. Amber Mullins.
Thank you.